Excuse me, we're married.
Get down from there, you're crazy.
Crazy for you.
Ow.
Leah, are you okay?
My tooth hurts because you're so sweet.
Jinx, what are you doing here?
What was he doing at the shop?
Well, apparently he was just staring at Clark and Leia's pictures all day. I'm actually worried that Jiggs might be up to something.
What is happening over there?
Looks like they're having a drink off.
Unbelievable.
Oh, this boy. Starlight, stand up! This is embarrassing!
Don't be shy. It's normal to have a crush. When I first saw your cousin Clark, I couldn't take my eyes off him. And he looked at me like...
Like this?
So that's how you make girls like you. You just look at them like this. That's your style, huh?
There's no style. I look at her like that because that's what I feel.
Jinx, you know how important the sash factory is to our family, right? It's our livelihood. You know that, right?
Of course I do. Why? Are you afraid that I might be up to no good? Is that it?
I've been texting Leia, but she hasn't replied to me yet.
She's in Ilocos right now, so maybe she can't get a signal.
This is unacceptable.
Welcome to Ilocos, Clark. Welcome to the family.
Hi, I'm Harry.
Divnia, what's wrong? I'm here to listen. Not as your suitor, but as your friend.
Everything that we thought we knew about our mother was all a lie.
If any one of you is going to be as unprofessional as Leia, you guys better leave my team.
I'm nervous about going to see my mom's family.
We need to visit them as a sign of respect. We have to tell them that we're getting married.
Hey, Mr. Saul.
Saulites.
Yes?
Did Leia really give McKenny to you already?
I guess she told me to take care of it.
Is that so?
Yes.
That bird was her mom's gift to her. She gave it away?
Well, maybe because she doesn't have time to take care of it. But she still visits McKenny on occasion. She even brings him some food sometimes. See you, Mr. Saul.
Oh, no, wait. What were you and Tiffany talking about earlier? Is there something wrong, Tolites?
What?
I saw the both of you talking over there. You both look serious.
Just a bit.
So, does Tiffany have a problem that I don't know about?
What? Mr. Saw, just because we were talking doesn't mean there's a problem.
She looked troubled while you were talking to each other.
Oh, not really troubled, just deep in thought. But Mr. Saul, I don't think I can tell you because...
Why?
Because it was about our relationship, a lover's talk. That's it.
A lover's talk? You two?
Mom, I have to go, Mr. Saul. Mom's calling.
Dennis, Rico, don't you guys really know what Jiggs is up to?
Is Jiggs planning something, Miss Jack?
Isn't that why I'm asking you guys? I'm hoping you might know something. I mean, I know he's been acting weird lately. Especially since he came back and fought with Clark.
He's been coming here often to drink, but I don't know anything else.
We don't really know. He's been quiet lately.
All right. But if you guys learn something, please tell me about it right away, okay? He might do something reckless.
Like what, Miss Jack?
I'm not sure. What I do know is, in his current state of mind, he'll do anything. That I'm sure of. He'll stop at nothing to prevent Clark and Leia's wedding. But we're not going to allow that to happen, right, boys? Thank you so much for visiting me, Leia. This means a lot to me.
Thanks a lot.
You know, the last time I saw you with your mom was when you were still a child. Now, you are all grown up. So the two of you are getting married, you say?
In a church, Grandma. Maybe early next year.
We hope you can attend our wedding. We'll even bring you to Manila. For your convenience.
Congratulations, Clark. Leia.
Grandma.
When I'm hugging you, it feels the same as hugging your...
Grandma? Do you already know the truth about Mom?
That she's alive. Yes. Very recently, she gave us a call. At first, we thought someone was just pranking us, but it was really her. Can you imagine? After more than 10 long agonizing years, Rana was alive all along.
Good evening. What can I do for you?
I have an appointment at 6 p.m.
Rana.
Yes, Doc.
Where the hell are the files I've been asking for?
Sorry, Doc. I'm on it.
Are you okay, Rona?
I'm okay. My back suddenly hurt.
I know how much it must have hurt your family because of what your mother did. As her mother, I'm ashamed of what she's done to you. I'm sorry, Leia. I apologize to you, to your sister, and your father.
Grandma, we haven't told Dad about it yet. He just had a heart operation.
Thank goodness you didn't, dear. That could be the death of Saul. She explained her situation to me, but I still can't accept what she did to your family. But despite that, I am still hoping. I hope she can make up for all her shortcomings to your family. I hope that someday she can correct all of the mistakes she's made.
Aunt?
Are you having a hard time breathing? Easy now. Whenever she gets emotional, she gets an asthma attack. That's enough, Mother. You'd better get some rest.
Hey, Harry. Just wait over here. I'll get the Jeep. We'll go to the sand dunes. We'll meet up with Leia and Clark there, okay?
All right.
This is weird. I saw you in Vegan, and now I see you here? Are you following me?
No. Of course not. I didn't expect to meet you there. I was quite shocked, actually. I wasn't, you know, following you.
Okay.
That's your style, huh, Clark? Maybe it wasn't an accident. Maybe it was destiny.
Are you okay?
Let's go, kids!
You're nuts.
Harry boy, it's all right. You know, it'll be tough for you because, let's be honest,
You're not as handsome as me and Clark, so...
Uh-huh, that's right. Hmm? More practice, kid. Rock's not dead. Let's go.
Tiffany, did I hear right? Are you and Tolite's a couple now?
What? Who did you hear that thing from?
Who do you think? Tolite's told me. I asked him earlier what you were talking about. You know what he said? He said it was a lover's talk.
Lover's talk? Is he dreaming or what? Look, Dad, don't believe what he says right away next time, okay? He's just pulling your leg.
That little punk. I knew something wasn't right. He was kidding around. But... Tiffany... What did you really talk about? Do you have a problem? Tiffany... If you need someone to talk to... I'm right here to listen. I'm your father. If you have a problem, you should at least tell me. I might be able to help out, even just to give advice.
Well, I can't really call this a problem, Dad. Because problems have a solution. This one doesn't. I got hurt because someone... was hurt and was deceived, and I got angry because of the actions of another person I used to love, someone who I used to fully trust.
Who?
I'm going to tell you everything, but not right now. I don't think I can talk about it yet.
All right, I respect that.
Whatever my mom does to make it up to us, I don't know if I can forgive her.
Leia, I'm not defending her. But if you find out what your mom's entire story is, you might better understand why she had to do all of that.
What else do I need to know at this point? Whatever explanation or reason she comes up with, she left us for another man.
Okay. Okay, relax. I'm sorry. We're not here in Ilocos to upset you. Okay?
Can we stop talking about my mom?
Okay, sure. No more talk about your mom. We're here on vacation. Come on. Let's have some fun. Push?
Push.
It's really a small world, huh? Who would have thought? Audrey's Leia's cousin.
Yeah.
Hey, shouldn't you be happy? I mean, you're with your crush.
She's not my crush or anything, okay? I don't know. Maybe. She thinks I'm weird, thanks to you.
What? Me?
The clock, look. I used it on her. And then she got creeped out. Your style is just...
Just what?
Lame.
What?
I didn't know you study in Manila.
Mm-hmm. Third year high school. I'm just on vacation here because it's our break.
You've been in Manila all this time and you didn't even bother to visit? Where do you live?
With my uncle from my father's side. I've been living with them ever since I got to Manila. Thing is, they're migrating to Australia next month. And they're going to sell their house before they leave. So basically, I'm looking for a place to stay.
Why don't you just come and live with us?
Really?
Yes, really. Although, our place is small. You might feel a bit cramped, but you'll enjoy it since it's fun there.
Don't worry. I'm cool with that. But will Uncle Saul be okay with it?
I'll have to ask first, of course, but I'm pretty sure he'll be happy to know you'll be living with us.
Like I told you, Harry, if Clark style doesn't work for you, there are more out there that just might do it for you.
That's right.
I already told you. What I've got isn't a style. It worked for me because when I look at Leia, what I'm feeling is real. And it shows in my eyes. It's not some pickup trick. It's real. So it has to be real for you too.
She's cute and all, but I just don't love her the same way you love Leia.
Which is fine. You're still too young. But when you're older, here's a tip. If you want a girl to like you, just be real. Be honest. Be a friend. Get to know her better. And the most important thing of all is don't be a chicken.
Exactly.
I don't know, Mother. Whenever I don't know where Jiggs is, I get really nervous. I don't know what he might end up doing.
What are you so afraid of? Clark and Leia aren't here anyway, right? And there's nothing Jiggs can do. He's not with Leia after all. All I'm saying is, Jack, stand firm, please. You have to make your son listen to you.
Mother, I just can't. It's not as simple as that. Here's the problem. Jiggs knows a secret about Leia's family that her father doesn't know yet. What if he decides to use that to prevent Leia and Clark from getting married? Right? It'll cause so much trouble. That will be disastrous. It's making me nervous.
Jack, listen to me. Trust your son a bit more. Do that, please. Weren't you the one who told me that your son is a changed man now?
I know that. But sometimes, Mother, when you love somebody so much, you tend to do things that you never thought you're capable of doing, especially when you're desperate. Then you wake up one morning realizing what you did and ask yourself why you did it in the first place. It happens.
Is this Veronica Wyatt, wife of Arthur Wyatt?
Yes. Who's this, please?
This is William Payne of Lifeline Insurance. I have good news for you, Mrs. Wyatt.
Hey, Mr. Nestor.
Hey, Jiggs, what's up?
Sorry for disturbing you. I just wanted to ask you something.
Jiggs, if this is about Clark and Leia, I don't know anything. Look, I have to go.
When are Clark and Leia coming back from Ilocos?
Your husband, Arthur Wyatt, was a client of ours. He had life insurance. And, as his wife and child, you are his beneficiaries.
There's money for us?
Yes, and it's yours to claim.
Thank you. This is more than enough. Brent, we can start over.
You mean, Dad left us money?
Yes, honey.
It looks like my relatives like you. I told you, didn't I? You had nothing to worry about. Once you got my dad's approval, his relatives would follow too.
Once we're back in Manila, we better start planning for our wedding. Can't wait to get married again.
Clark, we don't need to rush things right now. We still have to save money, remember?
Then let's start saving. As soon as we can. Because I can't wait to be with you every day, every night, every single day for the rest of my life.
Slaya, you have to see this. Come on, hurry, hurry. Come on, this way, look.
What is it, Axel?
Boss, it's awesome. Come on, you guys, let's go.
Come on.
Thank you for everything, Clark. I love you so much.
Yes, you belong to me.
I love you so much, Leia.
Thinking? Mom.
What?
Well, what are you gonna do with the money?
I'll save it. Use it for us. We're going to have a better life, Brent. I promise you that.
So, we're not going to the Philippines?
Brent.
I knew it. You want to go back there. You are going to use all that money just to go back to that family in the Philippines. Right?
I'm sorry, honey. But that's what I plan to do. We're going home to the Philippines.
Audrey is in high school now? And she's studying here in Manila?
If it's all right with you, Dad, can she stay with us for a while?
Because the relatives she's staying with right now are going back to Australia.
Well, of course she can. Hotel Olivar is always open to family. So, will she be coming back with you?
Oh, yes, Dad. We'll be leaving really early tomorrow.
All right, take care.
Oh, Leia, were you able to visit your
grandma, Ruby? How is she doing?
She's doing well, Dad. We caught up a bit. She and Aunt Baby send their regards. They said they're going to try and attend the wedding.
Well, I really hope they can make it then.
So even if your mom won't be there, at least her relatives
will be there at your wedding. So in a way, we'd still be complete.
Please try to understand. There are things that I need to do. Things I should have done a long time ago. That's why we're going to the Philippines.
You just want to be with your other family.
They're your family too, honey. Your sisters, if you only get to know them...
I don't want to get to know them. If you want to go, Mom, just go. But I'm not coming.
Brent!
Mom.
Simon, honey, how are you?
I'm okay, Mom. I'm
working on something.
Wait, you're working even on the weekend?
You're one to talk, Mom. I'm willing
to bet you're checking your students' papers
while we're on the phone. Right? How are you and Dad?
Oh, goodness, we miss you so much.
Listen, Simon,
you might be working way too hard. Take a break, or else you'll be married to your work.
I go out.
That's what I'm worried about, Simon. You keep
dating, but the girls you go out with
are like mannequins in a department store.
Beautiful on the outside and empty and lifeless on the inside.
No, they're not, Mom.
Oh, come on!
Isn't that why you haven't introduced
any of them to us? Not even one!
Mom, you're a literature professor, not a psychologist. And besides, I'm content with my life.
Don't you want to have a separate life from your work, Simon?
Mom, if she comes along, she will. If not, so be it. I'm content, Mom, so please, stop worrying about me.
Take care, okay? We love you.
All right, love you. Bye.
Been anyway. What took you so long?
Nobody asked you to wait for me, Mom.
Yes, I know. Nobody asked me to wait up for you. But I still chose to anyway. What if something happened to you? If you got into an accident or got into a fight, I should be ready, right?
If I get into a fight, I won't be the one who will get hurt. That will surely be my opponent.
I know that. All the more reason for me to be ready. Come on, son.
Mom, please. Can you not do that? Now's not a good time. I've got a bad headache.
Oh. What happened to you? Want some medicine?
Just get me water, please.
All right, wait here.
Thank you.
Jig's here. Unbelievable. Jig's, here's your water.
I'm fine, Mom.
Oh, goodness.
Leia, please look after Audrey, okay?
Okay.
We'll do, Aunt Darling. Don't worry.
Leia, this is for you and for your fiancé.
Grandma, what's this?
A fertility statue that came from Ifugao. As long as a woman has one, it'll help her get pregnant easily. That's believed to grant you many children.
Come on, Grandma. It's too early for that. We're just about to get married.
Thank you very much. We'll save it for future use.
Clark, come here, son. Now I understand why my son Solomon approves of you. But take care of our granddaughter, okay? Don't make her cry. If you do...
Don't worry about it, Grandpa. Chances are Leia will make me cry instead. Thank you very much.
Best of luck, son.
You be careful, okay? We'll see you kids again on your wedding day.
Okay, Grandma.
Come here.
Thank you.
Have a safe trip,
bye.
Okay?
Okay, guys, get comfortable. This is going to be a long trip.
Yeah! Rockstar Dad! Woo! Listen up. I have an idea. Let's start singing, you guys.
Go for
one,
it.
Two, three, four.
Haharanahin kita, saan tayo magpunta, hindi ko kahit wala lang balaga, o kaya biglang may breakfast in bed, just to keep you interested, lahat ay dahil wala lang.
Where is it?
Morning, Jacqueline.
Oh, Nestor. Look, we need to go to the shop now. We've got a delivery later.
You looking for something?
Yes, I can't find my cell phone anywhere. I don't know where it went. I had it with me last night. Can you call it, Nestor?
Sure.
I'm sure I had it last night.
Well, it's ringing.
Never mind. Let's go. The deliveries might come early. Where is that? Jinx, I'm leaving!
So, Cuz, did you enjoy your vacation?
Yeah. I enjoyed a lot, Clark. Thanks for bringing me along. Even though you were just forced to.
Only because you surprised me. Next time, let's hang out with Jordan and Jenny. Call it a long overdue hangout.
Can she come with us?
Sure. If she wants to.
What's wrong?
My boss Simon texted last night, but I didn't read it. I wonder why.
Thank you, Uncle Saul, for letting me stay here.
Don't mention it, Audrey. But I hope you don't mind that our home's a little bit cramped. Anyway, Tiffany's already preparing your bed. You'll share a room with her.
Oh, Dad, This is Harry, my cousin. He's from London, but he's here on vacation.
Welcome to the Philippines.
Thank you.
Clark, it looks like he took after your looks.
Now my entire family approves of you, Mr. Medina. There's only one thing left to do.
And what's that, Mrs. Medina?
Plan for our church wedding, of course. What else?
That's what I'm talking about!
Ralph's not dead! It's wedding time! It's wedding time!
Okay, let's get started next week.
Alright, let's just meet up tomorrow. Now get some rest. I know you're tired from driving.
I'll see you tomorrow, wifey.
Take care, okay?
See you, Leia.
Bye, Harry.
Bye, Miss Leia.
Bye, wife. Miss Leia.
Sure, Aunt Jack.
Don't forget the lanterns. Hang them after you're done with the lights.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, hi. Who's she?
This is our cousin Audrey. She's from Ilocos, but she attends school here in Manila. Her parents are from Australia.
Oh.
Kumusta nga? How are you guys doing?
She's Ilocano with an English accent.
Ooh.
Australian, Mama Lulu, because her mother is half Australian.
But I did grow up back in Ilocos.
Ah.
So you're an Australian Ilocano beauty. Hey, angels. We have a new neighbor with us. Let's welcome her.
Welcome to Tenement One. Enjoy!
Oh, my goodness.
Uh-huh, you'll love it here.
Wow.
Dig in, guys.
Oh, goodness. Hey.
Looks good.
Thank you so much, Clark. This looks delicious. I can't wait to eat it.
Miss Dar?
Grandma, watch your blood pressure. Don't eat too much, okay?
Kiko, you too. Don't eat too much. Take it easy.
But the long trip really took its toll on me, boss.
Come on, you're always hungry anyway.
Ooh. Chew your food.
Careful, careful.
You're eating like the world will end. Oh, my goodness.
And Jack, are you looking for something?
I've been looking for my phone. It's been missing since this morning.
Look for it later. It's just around here. Come and eat first.
Where could it be? Help me look later, okay?
Yes, later. Let's eat first. Goodness. Be careful next time. There are a lot of thieves nowadays. Eat up.
Jigs will pick you up. He'll bring you here.
Leia!
Did my mom text you already?
Yeah. Where's she now?
She's at home. She asked me to pick you up from here. So, let's go?
Jigs, do you know what this is about?
No idea. This was all she told me. So let's go. Mom's waiting for you.
Leia, where are you going?
Oh, I'm going to Miss Jack's house, Tolites.
If you want, I can give you a ride there, Leia.
Tolites, it's cool. I'll handle it. Mom sent me here to pick up Leia.
Jigs, I'm sorry. I mean no offense, but I just want to make sure that Leia's safe.
What's that supposed to mean? That I'm kidnapping her? That I'm planning to do something to her? Is that what you really think of me?
Jigs, relax, will you?
You know, if you two don't want to believe me, you can call my mom. Talk to her. So you'd be sure about this.
There's no need for that. It's okay, Tolites. I'll just ride with Jigs.
You sure about that?
I'll just come back right away.
How's your vacation so far, Harry?
Yeah, it was good. I think everyone enjoyed themselves, right?
Yeah.
And the food is great, right?
Was it better than my home cooking?
No, Grandma. You're the best.
I agree.
Thank you.
I really miss Grandma's cooking.
Thank you.
Clark,
thank
you. You're not going to miss Grandma's cooking if you come back home.
He's right, Clark. We don't always get to eat together like this. To be honest, I miss it.
I'm just near your house, so it's fine. We can visit each other anytime.
My only wish right now is for you and Jiggs to make up before Christmas.
Excuse me, guys. Hey, Taillights.
Clark, are you aware that
Jiggs picked up Leia from here?
What? Jiggs picked Leia up? When?
Just a while ago. He said your Aunt Jack texted Leia.
He said she wants to talk to her. That's why Jiggs went here to pick Leia up.
Is that true?
Trying to do? Why'd you bring me here anyway? Stop!
Don't you remember this place at all, Leia? This is where you and I first met. It was my birthday. I almost ran you over, but I avoided you, so I fell off my bike. You accompanied me to the hospital, Leia. Didn't leave me until I got treated for my wounds.
Jiggs, what are you trying to do?
I just want to remind you how we met, Leia. Simple as that. What you and I used to have. Before you met Clark.
What for, Jiggs? Come on already, your mom's waiting.
I sent you that message. Not my mom. I took her phone, okay? We were happy before, right, Leia? I love you. You loved me. Don't you remember that?
Are you really that desperate, Jiggs? You'd go as far as to use your mom's name to trick me? And get me to follow you?
Because you've been avoiding me! I've gone to your place many times. I've tried calling you so many times.
How many times do I need to tell you that you and I are done? We're over, Jiggs!
You and Clark have only known each other for a year. We were together for four. You loved me for 4 years. I worked very hard in America for you. I turned my life around for you.
Come on, Leia, pick up. Where's Jake's Aunt Jack? What if he does something to her?
Wait, I'll call him. Mom, can I use your phone, please?
Give me a second. What's going on? Here's my phone.
Hold on, I'm calling Jake's now.
I will do anything, Leia. Anything.
Jiggs!
Please.
Stop this already. Get up from
there. Give me one more chance.
Jiggs, get up, will you?
Leia, I love you!
Jiggs! Jiggs, stop it! Don't test my patience, I'm warning you!
Leia...
I do not love you! I love Clark, okay? We're married, we love each other, and that will never change! Just forget about me, Jiggs, and have some self-respect!
Fine, leave me! I'm going to tell your dad about your mom! She's alive, right? I wonder what his reaction will be when he finds out.
Don't you dare, Jiggs.
Leia, I'm not gonna do that. I won't say anything to your dad. If you leave Clark and come back to me.
You're blackmailing me? You're going to drag my father, my entire family into this? What if something were to happen to him, huh? Don't you care at all? Are you really that cruel, Jiggs?
So choose, Leia. Either you come back to me or I pay your dad a visit.
Even if I go back to you, we'd never be the same as before. I couldn't love you, especially if you did this.
Is that your decision? Don't say I didn't warn you, so don't blame me.
Jiggs! Clark?
Leia, where are you?
Clark, please help me. It's Jiggs. He's on his way to see my dad.